Alright, my PlayStation play has been very slow lately for some reason. But let's try and remedy that, shall we? I've been like falling asleep at night, like 9 o'clock, and then like not being able to sleep once I go to bed after, and oh, it's been brutal. I'm hoping to rectify everything starting tonight. I just gotta stay up all day long then until bedtime tonight. Which is a tall task these days, so, but we'll see. We'll see. Have not seen it. It on my map. Oh shit, I may have turned my. Oh. Marauder Goon. Oh, I wanted his. There we go.
I've always wanted to poke around in here.
Investigating.
Okay, see you soon. Oh, Jesus. Who the hell? He's coming right after me.
Yeah, huh? He's just interested in fixing stuff. He always used to follow me around, asking me to explain what I was doing. Like a puppy, kinda. I'm just glad he's alive. That he's okay. I mean, when Mr. Thompson said he was fired, we all expected the worst. If he wants to learn about engineering, we should help him get those data pads he wants. I'd like to do that for him. You mean about the mission being too clean? I know, but Vicker says the universe is a machine, that it runs by law. Real machines have gunked up oil, scratches, and worn bits. You can tell they've seen handling, been used by folk. The machine Vicker sees is one ain't never been run. It's not for people to live in. It's something on a museum shelf, under glass. Fixing the universe is a job for somebody way better than the likes of me. Nice.
I think I may just save this. All things considered. Here we go to the geothermal plant. Jabba. Oh. Thank you for that, Mr. Droid.
Send in the droidikas.
The control room should be off to the right. I hope we're doing the right thing.
What do? Oops. What do I have? I got a grenade launcher. I got a sawed-off light pistol, assault rifle, light pistol, light pistol. Oh, I do have a light assault rifle. Okay. Looks like I need some heavy. I don't think I have that though. I'm gonna buy that just to have. We're gonna go with this for now, and we are going to break some shit down. I did have one of those already. I think I'll keep maybe three of each thing. Oh, too late on this one. I got two of those. I got three of those. Alright, there, I freed up some room. There we go, okay. Repair bay. Receptionist is missing a head. Okay. We're gonna save this again just so I don't have to go through all that again. Here we go. Well, what's in here? This looks like it could be a repair bay. Be something fucking good in here. Did I not even need to unlock that door? There's a back door.
processing data, performing an air.
Now this place just keeps on going.
Get ready.
Thank you.
There it is. Can't she run down here? That's not the doorway. No, I can't get this. Got my little ring things and my donuts.
Great work.
Is that where I came in? I didn't even see that guy. Yeah. Okay. Okay, I'm just gonna save this. That was a good bit of progress there. Lots of junk collected.
three switches. That'll be easy enough.
Oh, that's why I can't run, because I'm too heavy, right? Oh, I'm wearing that one right now. Backups. Okay. Now I can run. Haha. Okay, where's that damn switch? This place before.
No, 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 just leave me alone. Go away, Phantom.
Mind the steam. You're liable to get scalded.
business sweeping.
Watch out!
Oh shit, they're everywhere. Oh no! Perks. Wait, where's that other one I had? I just upgraded.
Thank you.
My.
If we send the power to Miss McDevitt, what happens to the veil?
Processing. Beginning.
Here they come!
Jesus. Oh, there you are. Where the hell did he go? Did he fall over the edge? Okay. Yeah, okay, that one was barred before from the other side. That's... I've been there. Where is the pit, though? That's what I'm...
just leave me alone.
I'm guessing this is the pit. That could be a pretty good estimation.
No, just leave me alone.
That's in there. I'm just look over here first for any items. There it is.
Get away! You're not real. You're not real. Get away from me, Phantom. Shoot. Scram. You can talk? The Phantom's never talked before. I knew I shouldn't have eaten that sprat raw. See, Higgins? This is why you must always boil your sprats before ingesting. Clearly, I mistook you for one of the phantoms of my imagination, which terrorized me on occasion. Chester D. Higgins. The D stands for definitely not insane. I'll use it as a reminder. Oh, Higgins has been many things over the years. Sprat Wrangler, Saltuna Critic, Aetherwave Personality, Chairman of the Board, Galactic Defender, Sisty Pig Tycoon. I've come a long way for someone who started off as a simple engineer right here in this planet. Mechanicals lost their bolts. Opened fire on anything. It was pandemonium. I was on cleaning duty at the time. My old boss had me scrubbing pipes when the killing started. So, as usual, I missed out. I specialized in automechanicals, drones, sentries, repaired them, maintained, upgraded, did it all from my old workroom just over in the next section. Look, I don't want to fall into any trouble with the mechanicals. If they wise up to our plans, they will come for us with prodding irons. You know, you remind me of myself back when I was an intergalactic adventurer. I discovered a flaw. Their hostility levels were hardwired to maximum. There's no changing that, but you could rewrite their targeting protocol so they attack each other instead. There's a behavior control terminal in the other room. It should have options to change how the mechanicals act, including whom they shoot at. Oh, that reminds me. You'll need my passcode to access the behavior control terminal. Here, let me just write it down for you. The tail. Definitely start with the tail. If you're feeling adventurous, the ears are a particular delicacy. Jimmy'd opened the vending machines. That lasted a good couple of months. Eventually, I had to resort to more unconventional means of filling my insides.
Okay, so I got that passcode and I got the engineering guide. Definitely gonna get the carry more stuff upgrade next time.
Once we do this, there's no going back. Excuse me, ma'am. Look, I know you want your power regulator and all, but I just gotta ask you. Do you understand what you're about to do? I don't think you should cut off Edgewater's power. I think it would be cruel. I'm sorry. That just sort of came out all at once. Edgewater's hurting. We've been losing workers year after year, and corporate hardly ever sends replacements. There's barely enough Saltuna to fill our bellies anymore. But the town's got some good people in it. Decent, hard-working folk just living their lives the only way they know how. They don't deserve to be punished. Miss McDevitt's built something beautiful. Somehow, she's talked the ground into giving life again. It's plain to see she's made the Vale a better place. Fed the hungry, tended the sick. Gave a home to those that had none. But Miss McDevitt delights in Edgewater's suffering. She wants to hurt the town. Do you really want to be party to that kind of hatred? Well, that sure sounds like Mr. Thompson. If he was standing here, I imagine he'd remind us of how we're all one big, happy Spacer's Choice family. In Mr. Thompson's eyes, those deserters are still part of the Spacer's Choice family. The family must work together in order to survive. I hate to say it, but I think Mr. Thompson's got a point. Unless those deserters come back, Edgewater's as good as dead. Cutting off their power might be the only way. Sorry, I didn't mean to babble on like that. I felt like I had to say something.